ורחמיו יעשה שלום עלינו ועל כל עם ישראל.
גבירותיי ורבותיי, teaches us the Shulchan Aruch that there are some foods which are like bread, and the bracha for them is Hamotzi Lechem Min Haaretz, and you have to say Birkat HaMazon after you eat. There are some which are like cake, like cookies, pasta, things like this, which are Orei Min HaMazonot, and then afterwards when you finish you say Ala Mechia. This is the way it is for bread. So bread is called Lechem Pat in Hebrew. And cake is called pataba bekisnin. That's what it's called. What does that mean, pataba bekisnin? So the truth is that we have in the Beit Yosef brought down several opinions about what that is, because it's a machloket. So there's one opinion that says that pataba bekisnin, the Rambam says, that means it's something which is sweet, a sweet bread. Right? What does that mean? They put in there some honey, or they put in there some sugar. Comes out sweet, like challah, you know, challah. Like that, something like that. Ashkenazuri challah. So that kind of thing, says the Rambam, bracha is mezonot, not hamotzi. Why is that? Because since it's sweet, it's not really for meals, it's more like a dessert, you know, like some kind of a cake. Lekachia. It's lekachi. Right? Something like that. It's more like lekachi. So therefore, the Rambam says something like that is mezonot, it's not hamotzi. So now the question is, what about the other opinions, right? Let's get to the other opinions. That's the Rambam. There's also another opinion about Yosef. It says, it means bread which has kis. The word kis in Hebrew means pockets, you know? So what does that mean? You have pockets in the bread, and inside there's some kind of a filling in there. Whatever the filling may be, right? Yeah, we're going to talk about that. Yeah, you're right. It's a good point. It's a good question. Yeah. We're going to talk about that. We have to explain that. So, you have pataba bekisnin, so it's kis. What does that mean? Pockets. So, they make pockets out of the bread, you know, and they put filling inside, right? And this is our chachapuri and lobwani. That's what it is, right? Pataba bekisnin. It's dough, kadari, you know? And inside, there's filling in there. That's pataba bekisnin. That's also mezonot, right? That's number two. So then we have number three. There's another version of that, which is something which you're koses, kisnin, koses. What's koses? Something you eat it and it's crispy, you know? Parich. It's a parich. Right? Something like that, right? So if you eat like that, crispy, crackers, you know, like potato chips. That's potato. That's mashocher. We're talking about hamotzi, right? The mezonot.
Noise.
Right. What's the bracha for potato chips? Hadama. Hadama is the bracha. Not mezonot. What about shekel?
Chips.
Yeah. So there, the truth is that there are some Ashkenazim who make shekel on potato chips. You know which one? The Pringles. Why is that? The Pringles, because Pringles is right. But we, you know, it's a good what you're saying. Good question. So you know what the answer is to your question? That even though shakol covers everything, but if you know what's the real bracha, you shouldn't say shakol. We only say shakol when we don't know. You know, baposia. You know, safek. You know, then we say shakol. But if you know what's the bracha, so says the Chazal, tzarich lomar bracha mevureret. You know what's mevureret? Clearly. Miuchedet. Right? That's the idea. It's unique bracha for that food. So shekel we only say when we don't know what's going on, right? For these kinds of things. But there are some Ashkenazim who say shekel for Pringles. Right? What's the reason why? Because Pringles is not really potato cut, sliced. What they do is they make first powder out of it, you know? Kemach, you know? And then what they do is they put it together, stick it together. And then they fry it like that, or they put it in the oven, right? They bake it like that. So because they're making a kemach out of it, flour, this is the reason why some Ashkenazim, they make, on Pringles, they make shakol. But the truth is that our custom is to make hadama on all potato chips. Svadim. You know, more that's our custom. Anyway, that's a different issue. We're not going to talk about that today. Hadama is a different issue. But what I want to talk about is Pata Baba Kisni. So we said, right, there's also a third one, which is the Ke'achim. That's what we call it in Hebrew. Ke'achim means crackers, you know, something which is hard. And that's why the Sephardim, they have a custom, you know, that when it's not Pesach, so what bracha they make on Matzah? Mezonot, right? Ah, but on Pesach you made Hamotzi. Now you're making Mezonot? What happened? Lamorda. Manishtana halayla hazeh. What happened, right? What happened? So, you know what the answer is? The answer is that when you're eating it on Pesach, you have no other bread. There's no other bread. So this is your bread. So you make Hamotzi. But if you have some other bread, so then they say this is Ke'achim, you know, it's cracker, you know? It's hard, kashe. Parich, it's crispy. Therefore, right, the minhag of most of the Sfaradim, they make on Matzah, not on Pesach, they make Mezonot on it. Because it's crispy. So same thing with crackers, same thing with all kinds of things which are crispy. Things like this, right? There's many examples of all kinds of things they make like that, crispy stuff. So these are the three things which are called Pata Baba Kisnin. So the question is, what's the halakha, right? Which one do we go like? There's three opinions over here we just gave you. So comes the Shulchan Aruch and says, we go like all the opinions. Everything is halakha, all of them. So what does that mean? Whether you have something which is like the Rambam, who's it's very sweet, you know, like lekech, you know, so you make mezonot on that, like sweet challah. Right? According to Rambam, this is mezonot, sweet challah. The Ashkenazim don't do like that, right? What do? They make hamotzi on sweet challah, like Shimon said, right? That's the thing, you know? There's a question, by the way, what you do on Shabbat? On Shabbat, what you do? Because on Shabbat, you're making a seuda. So if you're making a seuda with sweet challah, right, what, did you make hamotzi or should you make mezonot? That's hamotzi, the question. Hamotzi. So Shimon says, you make hamotzi, right?
Yes.
I agree with him, by the way. I think he's right. He's right. But there are also Sfaradim, you know, many Sfaradim, also Sfaradim, on sweet challah, they make mezonot, even on Shabbat. You know, there is such a thing like this. So there's two different opinions, but there's one thing I can tell you for sure, right? It says, whether you have this mezonot or that mezonot, whether it is, whatever it may be, if you eat the size of four eggs, arba kabetzim, if you eat the size of four eggs of any mezonot, so then it becomes hamotzi and birkat hamazon. Why? Because you ate a lot. You made a seuda of it. You know, beri jama, beri. You know? So if you eat like, let's say, you know, like shalva, you know, makes over here, you know, hamzari, right? They make the khachapuri. So they make like, each one is like, you know, round like this meshulash, you know, like a triangle. So if you have like, let's say, three of those, that's already hamotzi because you ate it seuda. You know, it's not like one or two. Okay, one or two maybe. Even two, you know, safek, it's a safek.
Even one is more than 4x, I guess.
Ooh, yeah, but we don't count the filling, you know? We don't count the filling. We just count batokada. Only the dough. Right. You know, right, the cheese is not included, the lobio is not included, right in that, right? Or the potatoes. Right? That's the only the dough. So therefore if you have one hachapuri, you know, or one and a half, this is mezonot, right? You can make mezonot ala mechia. But if you have two or three, it's already hamotzi, you know? Because you're making a seuda. It's already 200 grams. 200 grams is four eggs. Same thing. Right? The exact amount is not 200, it's 220. Yeah.
Why and what we say shakol miyabi dvaro?
Because it comes from the potatoes.
What risky? Well, konyagi, what?
Same thing. It's all shakol. Why is that? Because they make a liquid out of it, you know? And it's mashkez, it's a drink. You know, it's not potato.
Yeah, no, why shakol miyabi dvaro?
Because it's not gefen, it doesn't come from vines, from grapes. So what are you going to make? Every drink is shekel. This is the rule, right? Except hagefen. Except wine.
Because
that's the rule.
So many things.
Every drink is shekel. Whether it's beer, you know, piwa, or orange juice, you know, whatever it may be, right? All the juices, all of them are shekel. Everything is shekel. The only thing which is borei pri hagefen, what is that? Grape juice, right? And wine. That's it, right? All the other things, they're all shekel. So, as we said, right, coming back to our issue, if you eat four egg sizes of any mezonot, you're making a seuda, kovea seuda. So now you have to say hamotzi, and you have to say birkat hamazon. And also you have to wash your hands, you have to do netilat yadayim also. Yeah, because you're making her, you're making a seuda. Yeah.
I have a question.
Yeah.
So we were told that if you don't have wine and you want to bless the agafen, right, and you don't have wine, you can drink beer, white beer.
Oh.
Right?
Yes.
And if you drink white beer, you still say agafen or shepherd?
You're asking about kiddush, right?
Yeah.
Or havdalah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So the halacha is like this, right? That if a person is making kiddush or havdalah, he doesn't have wine at home, you know? The truth is he should, you know? Try to have some wine, because that's the real mitzvah, is to make kiddush and havdalah on wine. The main mitzvah is like this. But if he has no wine at all, no grape juice, nothing, so what does he do? He makes his own beer, you know? And what does he say? Shakol. He says shakol. That's all right.
He says shakol.
Shakol, yeah, of course. Yeah. That's the way it's done. And if you're making kiddush on challah on Friday night, you make hamotzi. That's also kiddush. You can make kiddush on challah. You know, how do you do that? First you do netilat yadayim. Then you go make kiddush. And instead of saying bor pri hagefen, you say hamotzi lechem min haaretz. You take challah and you eat. This is also kiddush. Only at night though, not in the morning. The morning doesn't work. Doesn't work in the morning. So, okay, getting back to what we said, right? So what are we saying over here? If you have four egg sizes, it's already hamotzi lechem min haaretz and katamazon. But now the question is like this, right? What about things like pancakes, you know, or blinebi, blintzes, right? Right, but now I'm asking you a question. If for sure it's mezonot, no question. But the question is like this: what about if you eat four egg sizes of four pancakes? You had four pancakes. Now you make hamotzi and brikat hamazon. So the truth is, it's a machloket, you know, in the achronim regarding that. Why is it machloket? The reason is because pancakes, it's different than chachapuri. What's the difference? Or labwani. It's not the same thing. No, there's flour there. They have flour there. But the thing is like this. You know what the difference is? Chachapuri, all the other cakes in mezonot, they're made in the oven, the tanur. But this is made in the pan. You know, it's pancakes, right? Pan. Made in the pan. Machabat. So since we're making in a pan, there are poskim who say that when you make something in the pan, you never say hamotzi on that. It's always mezonot, no matter how much you eat. Even if you eat 2 pounds, you know, of pancakes, right? You're still going to make mezonot.
But chachapuri also you can make on a pan.
Yes, you can. But if you made it in the oven, then it's going to be hamotzi, right? Most of the time we make it in the oven, most of the time. I'm assuming, right? You can make it also in the pan, yeah, for sure, no question, yeah. If you made it in the pan, then it's the same as pancakes. That's the rule, yeah. So you have to know how it's made. Usually it's made in the oven. But anyway, right, as we said, so pancakes, what about sufganiyot, donuts, right? What's the story with that? So the truth is, you know, sufganiyot, the real sufganiyot, ponchikebi, you know, they're fried in oil. Yeah. So therefore, on sufganiyot, we never make hamotzi, even if you eat a lot. We don't make hamotzi on that, according to what we just said, right? Because why? Because it's made in the pan, right? It's a deep fry, whatever they call that, right? It's not in the oven. But the truth is, I must tell you that, you know, when I was in Israel, over there, sufganiyot is a big thing, you know? It's a big business over there, sufganiyot in Israel. $1 billion business over there. So I must tell you, you know, that there are some sufganiyot in Israel which are made in certain bakeries, you know? And they're very delicious, very special, very beautiful. You can't find over here like sufganiyot like that. Much better than anything over here, you know? By the way, you should know, the food in Israel is much better than it is over here. Everything is better there. Everything tastes better.
You're talking to an expert here.
He's an expert. You can't compare the food that we have here than the food they have there. Everything tastes better over there. Barakianik, you say, you know, it's like a dalot suli abgilia, you know? It's a blessed land, you know? Eretz HaKodesh. Everything tastes better over there. Whatever it is. You go to a restaurant over there, you have shawarma, and shawarma over here, it's like a different world, you know? No taste over here, shawarma. Nothing. Yeah. Chala, you know? Nothing. Over there, shawarma is really shawarma. You know, it's a blessed land. You know, everything is blessed over there. Baruch Hashem. You know, also the chefs are good there. There are good chefs over there. Very professional people who are cooking over there. You know, I must tell you that you should know. By the way, I think I mentioned it before, but Right now, you should know, most of the Jews, the Rova Yehudim, most of the Jews, where are they in the world? They're in Israel, not here in America. Now the majority of Jews are in Israel. So what does that mean? We should start packing and going, you know, if we can, you know, going back there, right? What are we doing over here? I don't know. I still don't understand what we're doing over here. I'm not really sure. But, you know, life in Israel is good, Baruch Hashem. You know, whoever can afford to go there, he has some money saved up, he can buy an apartment, he can buy a house, he can buy a car. You should go and move over there. Why not? You know, live over there in Eretz Israel. Eretz HaKodesh.
You don't have suitcases. Suitcases are problem. Suitcases are problem.
Where is your flight?
Oh, wow. Whoosh. You know what? I want to take a flight. You know what's holding me back? They make you wearing a mask. I can't wear a mask for 12 hours. What kind of thing is that, you know? Shem Yirachem. I want to go so much, but the mask is holding me up now.
They have now masks.
It breathes, huh? Soon comes, soon comes.
It's probably clean for
you. Okay.
Or you can have oxygen in your pocket.
Because we all have to go back, you know? Believe me, seriously.
Seriously. You know, small balloon.
Whenever I can go back, Shimon, whenever I can go back, I will go back right away. I'm not even going to ask anybody. I'm just going to go. I'm not even going to tell anybody over here. I just won't see them anymore. That's it, I'll be gone. If I can go back, I will. God bless you. Okay, so anyway, getting back to what we said, right? As we said, that depends on how much you eat and also how it's prepared. If it's made in a pan, it's always going to be mezonot, no matter what. What about pasta? Right, spaghetti, vermicelli, you know, all kinds of macaroni, all kinds of stuff like this. What's the bracha? And what about if I have arba betzim, four eggs? Should I make mezonot? Should I make hamotzi? Huh? Shekel? Why shekel? Why? What's the reason? Why? So you know what the poskim say? I'll explain to you something interesting. You're right what you're saying, but you have to give a reason also, right? So the reason is like this. They say that the pasta, en no to'ar lechem.
Yes.
What, you know what that means? It doesn't look like bread. You know? It doesn't look like something else. Yeah. So since it doesn't look like bread, it looks like some kind of dish, you know? Some kind of cooked dish. Tavshil, you know? It doesn't look like bread. So therefore, they say, whatever doesn't look like bread, you're never going to make on that hamotzi lechem min haaretz. It has to look like bread, you know? So what looks like bread? Like, you know, like borekas, you know, hachapuri. That looks like bread, you know, more or less. You know, it's pretty much the same. You know, it's the same, it looks the same. So that's the idea, you know? Also, one more thing I want to tell you when we stop. We do Arbit Mezud Hashem. Another interesting machloket is, we talked about this already, about things which are like sweet today, you know, sweet bread. Now we talked about this, right? According to Rambam, sweet bread is mezonot. But even the Rambam admits, by the way, you should know, obviously, right? The Rambam admits that if you have arba betzim, four egg sizes, 200 grams, it's already hamotzi, because you'll be kovei aser adam. So if you eat like two big slices of challah, two big slices, you know, skelevi, you know, it's hamotzi already for sure, according to everybody. You know, so if you're eating like a big meal on Shabbat, and you're having two thick slices of challah, it's already 200 grams. It's already hamotzi, according to everybody. This is your bread on Shabbat. This is the custom of the Ashkenazim. They eat sweet bread on Shabbat. So since this is their custom, this is their bread, this is their seuda, so therefore they make hamotzi. This is the reason why. You know, and by the way, I want to tell you something, that it's possible that even the Rambam would agree with this. I'll explain to you why. Because the reason why the Rambam says that sweet bread is mezonot is because in his country where he lived, where did he live in Rambam? He lived in Mitzrayim, right? Then he moved to Eretz Israel, right? Afterwards. He was in the Sephardi countries, in the Eastern countries. He also lived in Spain for a while as well, when he was younger. But the point is like this, right? That the reason why the Rambam writes that sweet bread is mezonot is because we don't make seudot in those countries with sweet bread. It's like cake. It's like, you know, lekachia. You know, it's like lekech, you know? So in those countries, arakateb and seudah sasa. Sakatelo shakateb, then. In Georgia, they made seudot with sweet challah? Seudah. No. Yeah, that's it, you know, this is the reason why. But here in America, they do. Over here, you know, you go to a restaurant, right?
Which one is better?
whatever you like, this is the better. This is whatever you like. That's gechali seudah.
This is the...
You know? So, what I'm telling you is like this, right? Even the Rambam may admit that if you're going to a country where they make over there seudot with sweet bread, that's going to be hamotzi. Why is that? Because this is your seudah. This is what you're eating, your seudah. You cover your seudah with that. There's a big machloket about this, by the way, you know? There's one side, Maran Ravadia, you know, he says that it's always mezonot. There's also Rav Moshe Levi and others who say it's gonna be hamotzi. If you're eating a meal, kovya seuda. There's all kinds of opinions about this. So either way, you have what to rely on, you know? If Shimon wants to do seuda Shabbat with sweet chalot, no problem, you can do. Because you have what to rely on.
That's what his name, Hala.
Yeah, you're right. Okay, very good. If you wanna do like the Rambam, you know, like the Sfarim, the most of the Sfarim they do. So then you're going to make always mezonot on sweet challah, unless you have 200 grams, right? 200 grams, as we said, two thick slices of challah or two challah rolls. That's already four egg sizes. So you already, it's going to be hamotzi for everybody, according to everybody.
You have so much bread now. If you want to diet,
yeah, we have to make a diet. Okay. Baruch Adonai Le'olam, Amen Le'amen. רבי חנניה מלך אשר אומר, אז כמו שבוע זה, יתיר לך חרבה להם תורה מצוו, שאונו נחפץ למען צדקו יגדיל תורה בידי.
I'm sorry.